Hey everyone, Ricky here from Ricky's Tech Talk for another basics video today on the Honor 50. In this video, I'm going to go through the setup process step by step. And if you have any questions, leave a comment below the like button and I will make sure to be there to help. Before beginning, I just want to highlight that this has the accessibility features has returned thanks to the device having Google services back on it. So it's running Android 11. We can see the options inside the visual section here. So you've got magnification or font size. I might just jump into font size, make it a little bit easier for me to read as I'm going through the setup process with you. And we can come back again. You can also have talkback where it will narrate everything back to you as well. And you can toggle that on by pressing and holding the two volume keys down the right hand side together at the same time. Just want to highlight there's no textual difference or color difference with the power button though. So make sure you press the right buttons. You'll get used to this though as we go along. So moving into the setup process, what do we have first? We have welcome and you choose your language. If you need to make an emergency call, you can do. You will need to put in a SIM card into your device. Don't currently have one at the moment. Select your region, again, United Kingdom, pressing next. Terms of use, so you have to agree to terms of use, click the boxes and next. Insert SIM card, we're going to skip this process, which means then we do have to actually add our Wi-Fi connection. So what you need to do is choose your Wi-Fi. Mine is this one under here and add your password in. You can see the keyboard for the first time, nice and large, thanks to a nice large display. I'm just going to type in my password. Once you've typed in your password, we can then hit connect. Once connected, it will turn blue and say that it's connected, which is really helpful. We're going to hit next. Now it's going to check for any software updates or any updates that the phone may need. Again, if you had a SIM card inserted, it will check for this as well. Now we have the option to copy apps and data. So this is maybe your new phone and you want to copy from a previous device or change even from brands, from Apple over to Android. What you can do is hit next and you select what you're doing. So a backup from Google or from an iPhone device. And then if you click on here, it gives instructions and you can go through and do that if you want to. Same with the Android, if you clicked on the Android ones, or if you had a Google Cloud backup, you could log into your Google account, which we'll be doing shortly, and download that backup again to help. I'm gonna say don't copy. I like to set my devices up fresh and new. Again, it will be checking for information. The next step is to sign into Google. So Google has returned with their Google services, including their apps, and also importantly, including the Google Play Store. You can sign in or you can create an account. Tap create an account and it'll take you through the process of signing up. Again, I'm just gonna log in now. So give me a couple of minutes to log in. I'll be right back. So once you've signed in, it will welcome you and you have terms and conditions that you need to agree to. And I agree to these because I want to use all the services. Again, Google is getting all your services and bringing your information down. Time and date, is that correct? Yes, it is. I can't believe we're in November already. So Google services, you have a range of Google services. I recommend you take some time to read through these. And it's all about the app locations, installing information, your location, just so you can choose which you want to use. I turn off backup because of the amount of devices I have on the channel. It would just be filled instantly. So I'm going to accept the rest and move on. Again, it always seems to just be checking and moving forwards. So here in UK and Europe, now we have to choose which search provider we want. I'm going to go for Google. And it gives you options here why you should choose them, who they are, and it's fine. I'm just going to choose Google. Next. To see what's trending with Google Assistant, yes, that's fine. It'll send information. It'll update your device. Activate voice match file for your phone. This is correct. If this is your first time, it'll get you to say certain phrases, and I agree. So it's listening out for those certain phrases, and then we'll activate, and you can ask to send a message, get a call, get information. Data and privacy, again, we agree to this. You have device protection, which is very important. So we've got fingerprints, we've got the face recognition, And also you've got set password. So it's up to you what you choose. So I'm going to choose fingerprints. It's going to ask you then to choose a PIN as a backup. I'm going to just drop this down to a 4-digit PIN, and you could have a pattern or password. And I'm just going to put in my PIN now, and it will ask you to repeat this. So once that's done, it will then make the screen go black because it uses an optical underscreen fingerprint reader. We're going to hit OK. We're going to hit OK again. And it highlights the section that you need to press. And as you can see, I'm just filling in. If I didn't do it quite right, it would tell me as well. So now you're going to do the edges, and all you do is like you're doing the sides and the bottom and top parts of your finger. Oops, just need to do that one little edge again. Then it'll ask you to do other parts, bottom, we're all done. So continue, and you can add other ones as well if you want to. So let's go next, enhanced services. I like to use these, that's fine. User Experience Improvement Program, again, you can join these. Location Services, I enable just because I want to use the device. So New Navigation Gestures, so let's give it a try. So you've got gestures here, so we can swipe this way to come back, which is nice. You can swipe this way. You can swipe up. You can swipe up and hold. That'll show all of your applications. Great, that's fine, finish. And then we're into our home screen. So welcome to the home screen of the Honor 50. Sitting there nice and proud is the Google Play Store. That will have all of your information there from Google. You've got the applications as well that you know from Google, such as YouTube for me. So make sure to come and subscribe to Ricky's Tech Talk to stay updated with all of my latest videos, including the unboxing and including the full review. So coming over to this side, you'll get updates from Google, and it will give you information. So once I load, it'll be the news feed that you like and stories, which is good. But that is it for the setup process of the Honor 50. However, if you do have any questions and queries, please make sure to leave a comment underneath that like button, and I will happily get back to you. From me, Ricky, have a great weekend, because I'm filming on the weekend. If not, and it's during the week, stay safe, stay well, and I will see you in my next video. Bye for now.